Hello guys! In this video we'll speak about Grunge.js. If you're watching this video, you probably already know what is Grunge.js. For those of you who don't, Grunge is a small yet quite powerful task runner for JavaScript. Well, technically it is not limited to JavaScript, but historically it's mostly used for Node.js project and client-side JavaScript project, and most of its tasks are designed to support building those projects. So, without further ado, let's install Grunge and see what it can do. In this video, we'll see how to install Grunge and run the simplest possible Hello World task. So, let's do that. First thing, I'll create a new folder to hold our project. I'll call the project Grunter. So, the next thing to do is obviously to initialize package.json. Since this is a project for Node.js, probably we'll need package.json. npm init, I will answer the default answers to all the questions. And here's the basic default package.json. So, now we need to install Grunge. Grunge comes as two parts. Grunge command line interface, which is installed globally. This is a global command Grunge. And the second part is Grunge itself, that is installed locally on the project. So let's install both parts and then I'll tell why Grunge decided to do such a separation. So first we'll install globally the Grunge command line interface, Grunge CLI. Done, and now we will install the Grunge itself to the project folder. So I will call npm install with the flag save dev to mark Grunge as the development dependency. Have some warnings because my package.json is not perfect, but that's okay for the sake of this simple demo. So now Grunge is installed, and to check that everything is okay, call Grunge minus minus version. It should show you both the version of CLI command line interface and Grunge. So why having two different parts, Grunge CLI and Grunge? Well, the answer is quite simple. Grunge CLI is only responsible for running your Grunge locally. And this is done to support different versions of Grunge residing in different projects. So let's say your friend builds with Grunge version 0.3 while you have Grunge 0.4 installed on your system. Let's say that the change is broken, so Grunge 0.3 doesn't work the same way. If Grunge were installed globally, then you'll have a single Grunge for every possible project. And to build the project of your friend, you would have to downgrade, which is a pain. And in this way, when you have separately the command line interface and the Grunge itself, you can have every project having its own small version of Grunge. And since Grunge is not that big of a download, this is not a problem. But the benefit is huge. You have every project built in a controlled environment with exactly the version of Grunge that you need. So now we are ready to create our Grunge file, an entry point for every Grunge. So I'll start from creating a file, it's spelled uppercase, and let's edit it. Grunge file.js is a simple Node.js application. So what you have to do is to export a single function that accepts a single argument Grunge. Like this. And this variable Grunge gives you the access to Grunge API. So now let's register a simple task and see if it runs. Grunge register task. This is a function that accepts three parameters. First is the task name, call it greet. Second is a task description, greet the user. And third is function that is a task itself. Won't do anything funky here. I'll just print console log hello world. Now Let's save this file and run it from command line as a grunt build script. Grunt, and the second parameter is a task name that you want to run, greet. Hit enter, and you'll see that the build is successful. So grunt is reporting that it is running a greet task. A task itself prints hello world to console, and grunt says that build is done without errors. So congratulations, you just have the right first step to make your own grunt file, grunt build file, and you know how to declare and create your own specific task. In the next video, we'll see how to create multiple tasks, how to define a default task, and how to add parameters to the task. Stay with me.